What's going on, everybody? So today we are going to be solving the largest allowable load P that we can put on this truss member without exceeding a change in length of 1.6 millimeters in member BD. So what's that saying is I want to put a load on the point C here of the amount P. But I want to push as much pressure as I can through here to the point to where I don't exceed stretching this member BD any more than 1.6 millimeters. How do we do that? Well, we have some values here. They're modulus elasticity of BD. Let's go ahead and write this down while we do it. So modulus elasticity of BD is equal to 200 gigapascals, or 200 times 10 to the ninth pascals. We know our area is of BD is 1920 millimeters squared. And to keep our units the same, we're going to go ahead and change that to meters squared. So 1920 times 10 to negative 3 meters squared. What else do we know? So we know the height and we know the width. So from knowing these two values, we can figure out the length of BD. And that is using Pythagorean theorem. So 6 squared plus 5 squared. So the square root of this length squared plus this length squared is going to give you the length of BD. And that will equal 7.81 meters. So there's an equation that we could use, and it calculates the stress caused by a material that cannot expand, and that gives us the change in length of a material is equal to a force P times a length divided by its area times its modulus of elasticity. Yeah, we know all this information except for P, right? Now this P isn't going to be directly related to the P we're looking for. This P is going to be the force in the member of that these values are pulled from. So all the values we have, so we have L, we have A, and we have E, and we have our change in length, it's given here of 1.6 millimeters, are all from member BD. But if you remember from doing stress structure analysis that all the forces at a point, say point B, all these forces should add up to zero. So if we can figure what the force is in BD, so instead of P, we're going to make that F of BD times L of BD over the area of BD times modulus elasticity of BD. So that's going to allow us to rearrange this to solve for the force in BD. And once we have the force in BD, then we can do our free body diagram at B and do our sum of forces. And then from our sum of forces, we can find P. So let's start off by putting all our information in and finding what F of BD is. So rearranging this, we'll get F of BD is equal to E of BD times A of BD times the change in length of BD over the length of BD. And inputting all these values, we get F of BD is going to be equal to 78.67 times 10 to the third newtons. And I know I didn't have the change in length written here, so I'll go ahead and write it here. Change in length of BD. And I was given in a problem. 1.6 millimeters. Or 1.6 times 10 to the negative third meters, if we're trying to keep all our units the same. So now that we have our force in BD, now we can go back and analyze our truss structure. So if we're looking at the point B here, we know that we have some force acting through A going to B of FAB. We know also that we have some force, P. We don't know what it is, but we know there's a force here because that's the one we're trying to find. And then the one we just calculated is also here, and that is F of BD. And knowing that the sum of forces is equal to mass times acceleration, we know everything is stationary, it's static. Nothing is moving here, so it all has to equal zero because our acceleration is zero. So we know the sum of forces. Now we're going to only look in the x direction. This force P x and our y. So our force P is only running in the x direction. So nothing in the y direction is going to help me solve this force P. So I'm only going to look for the sum of forces in the x direction. And that should equal zero. So let's go ahead and label to the right is positive. Anything that goes to the left is going to be negative. So we need to find the x portion of our force of BD. Now one way we can do that is we know it's going to be this right here, which is sine of this angle theta. Now we don't know angle theta. Yes, we can do the trig and figure it out. But one easy way to do it is knowing that sine is opposite over hypotenuse. So our opposite is 5, and our hypotenuse is the length of BD, which is 7.81. So this fraction is going to give us the sine function, and we need to multiply that by the force BD, which is 7.867 times 10 to the third. All right, so we have our x component of F of BD, and the only other force acting in the x direction is P, but it's going the opposite way, so we're going to subtract P, and that should all equal zero. If we move P to the other side, we're going to get P equals 5 over 7.81 times 78.67 times 10 to the 3. So that's going to give us 50.4 times 10 to the third newtons, or 50.4 kilonewtons. So there you have it. If you're looking for a max force you can put on a member without exceeding a certain length change of another member, this is the easy way to find it. Hope this helped you out. If you liked it, give it a thumbs up, and I'll see you on the next problem.